So I will talk a little bit about my Monster High obsession. I've always loved dolls, like forever, ever, ever. Like even when I was little, I was a little brown Filipino girl in Arizona. I just had this huge obsession with Barbie dolls. So for the longest time, I did collect Barbie dolls. Even as I became an adult, I collected Barbie dolls. I do still have a few Barbie dolls. I did sell a lot of them when I moved overseas to Dubai because I really needed money. So that was a little bit sad, but I still have some left over. And then when Monster High came out when I was in Dubai, that was a lot of fun. They were just really crazy and spooky, and I actually saw them debut at San Diego Comic-Con 2000 and, oh shoot, maybe it was before I moved to Dubai. I think it was before I moved to Dubai. 2010, I think, is when it came out. And I actually got the Frankie exclusive. And I still have it, and I try to get my San Diego Comic-Con exclusives every so often. Hi, Boney, one of my mods, and my husband, actually. He doesn't like my Monster High collection, but too bad. So, as you can see, I am wearing a Ghoulia shirt. And yes, before you have to ask, this is a child's shirt. I know. But I can still fit into it, so that's great. And Ghoulia is my favorite monster. I'm not, like, huge on horror. Like, monsters are cool. I have this, like, love-hate relationship thing with zombies. So that's why Ghoulia is my favorite. I am a huge Walking Dead fan, so that might come up in another stream some other day. But dolls, why do I love dolls? I love dolls because it's just, like, the artist in me loves what can be created in such a small scale. So I'm just going to show you one of the dolls that I have. And I don't unbox many of my dolls. Pretty much, I would say 99% of them are still in boxes. I only unbox them if maybe I really, really like it and it was not expensive. Or I have dupes, which is very rare. But I did have to unbox this one. This is Rochelle Goyle. So obviously, for those of you not familiar with Monster High, Rochelle is a daughter of the Gargoyles. Dun, dun, dun. And she's French as well. Ooh la la. So this was actually part of the Freak du Chic collection, which I love this collection because it's just so amazingly cute. So all the characters have like different circus characteristics. So I had to unbox Rochelle because she came in this giant playset, and I found her for a really good price. I found her for like 15 bucks with this playset. So as you can see, she's still actually on her swing. And I don't think I'm going to take her off because it's just so cute and she stays on there really well. So this is Rochelle on her swing, and I did unbox Rochelle, and it was a lot of fun unboxing all that stuff. I just love these dolls, you know. I have to say that Mattel does a really great job with dolls. The Monster High ones, I just love the detail and the fashion that they put into it. Unfortunately, Mattel did a reboot of Monster High dolls, and I'm not a fan of the reboot. I feel like, I know these are for children, I know. I'm like a 33-year-old woman playing with dolls, but oh well, who cares? And the reboot just looks so childish, and like they didn't put any thought into the fashion, and they just put random colors. So I'm a huge fan of the original Monster Highs. Plus, they haven't brought Ghoulia back into the reboot, so that's a little bit upsetting. So this is one of my favorites, and I just love her hair. Isn't it so cute? I wish I had hair like this. So this is Rochelle. Rochelle Goyle from the Freak du Chic collection, and there she is in her cute little dress. And oh my god, these shoes. Like, any woman would like actually die for these shoes. So, with little bows on the side. So yeah, that is one of the dolls that I have unboxed. Ta-da! So another doll that I have not in a box, and this is an unfortunate thing why she's not in a box, is because when I first saw her in stores, I didn't get her, even though mermaids are like my absolute favorite thing. I'm not like an ocean person or anything, I just really love mermaids. So I didn't buy her at the store. I bought Avia Trotter, which is in the same line, but she's a half harpy, half horse. So I bought her instead, and then I totally regretted it because this doll was so hard to find. She was on the floor, don't be mad. She was actually, this one I bought online from a Facebook group, and she was out of the box because in box they're like 40 or 50 bucks. so which I really regret. This is from the Freaky Fusion line, and these aren't the original characters. These are characters that were made temporarily for the line and for the movies, because you know they have movies to go with every doll line. So this one, Serena von Boo, is a mermaid slash ghost. So the whole point of the Freaky Fusion thing was like, you know, different monsters falling in love and having mixed children, which, you know, I'm going to have mixed children one day. I'm going to have little half white, half Asian babies. Isn't that right, Ellen? One day. But they won't be able to play with my dolls. No, definitely not. So this is Serena von Boo, and she's in really good condition. The previous owner took her out of the box and displayed her. So she wasn't played with. She was just on display, and she's beautiful. So that is Serena von Boo. Oh, she's got two different, so you can actually stand her. She's a really beautiful doll. Haha. Nice. So, on the doll, in the dolls for the ghost, they have like kind of clear see-through arms and stuff and legs. Well, she doesn't have legs, obviously, because she's a mermaid. So Serena's kind of got these kind of see-through-y arms with like webbed fingers. So that's really cute. So this one, if I had bought it in a box, I would not have opened it, but for now I've got her unboxed until I can get one. So that's Serena. That's another one that I have unboxed. I did buy a lot loose dolls. Don't freak out. I bought a few loose dolls because my next venture that I want to get into is doll repainting. Now, I'm not a painter. I mean, I did draw a lot in my younger years, and I am artistic in a way. Painting, I've only started painting stuff for cosplay reasons in the last year or so, or last 2 years. So doll painting obviously is going to be a lot different because you've got to do all these intricate designs. So I do have a couple of loose dolls that I bought that I'm going to try and repaint. So that's another one that I have unboxed. Now, I do have these unboxed. These are the Fright-Mares. Now, these are tiny little, as you can see, in comparison to the actual full-size dolls, they're tiny little they're like centaurs that live underground the Monster High School. Yeah, I know a lot about Monster High. It's a bit ridiculous. And this one is a favorite of my cousin, Kathy. I hope Kathy comes in to see this at some point, but this is 14, and she's a little doe girl. But anyway, they live in the catacombs of the Monster High School. So I do unbox these because they're fairly affordable, you know, and they're just so cute, and you know, I want to display them. So I do have two that I'm going to unbox today. So, ta-da! This is 14 Fallow Heart. And they're just so cute. And yeah, they do have greasy box hair, but that's okay. So, what I'm going to do today is I'm going to unbox Zomby Gaga. So, Zomby Gaga is an official partner. Oh, I can't get the glare off of it. An official partner with Monster High. So, Lady Gaga, this is official Lady Gaga doll. And she partnered up with Monster High to do this special Zomby Gaga doll. As you can see, this classic look that she has. From, I think it was Art Pop. Oh, I do like Lady Gaga, I just haven't kept up with a lot of her work lately, so that is Zombie Gaga, Boy Gaga, I guess, I think it was. And you can see Monster High, and it says, Born This Way Foundation, so proceeds empowering youth and inspiring bravery. So I think it was proceeds went to this, was her foundation. And I have two. Where's my other one? Oh, yes, I do have two. And I did pre-order them on Amazon when I saw them for the sole purpose of, my keyboard because it's glaring on this, so for the sole purpose of unboxing one. So one I'm going to keep in the box. Ta-da! Oh, focus. One I'm going to keep in the box and the other one I'm going to unbox. So that's going to be a lot of fun. So like I said, I don't unbox a lot of them. So unboxing is quite exciting. I think I'm going to unbox... Well, I think this one, because actually her hair is coming out a little bit. Both boxes are in pretty good shape. I'm not one of those collectors that like care that much about the box. But what's nice, oh wait, no, I was going to unbox this one because the sticker's coming off in the back. But what's nice about this one is that it actually comes with a spare outfit underneath. So it would go to waste if you didn't unbox it, I think. I mean, she's really, really cute, and even the box is amazing. So this one's gonna stay in the box. So let's put her there so y'all can see her. Ta-da! Okay, and then this is the one that I'm going to unbox. Focus, ta-da! Now, this is my first unboxing video. Usually when I unbox things, I just open them up like a child. So I'm gonna try and do this and talk along as I go. And then when I'm finished, I do have some other things I might unbox. We'll see how it goes. So, for those of you just joining us, Monster High Zomby Gaga, we're going to unbox her. Yeah, sorry, my computer screen, obviously you can see that I'm watching my feed because I'm still new at this. So let's get started. I don't want to really rip the box apart, but there are two little sticker tabs that actually came off really easily. Oops. Oh, everything's backwards. I'm still getting used to it. So two sticker tabs here, which I think they made it so it was easy to unbox. Ta-da! Yeah, that was nice. Put my scissors aside in case I don't need that. And, oh, it even says, tattoo artwork inspired by Zombie Boy. Find out more at rickgenist.com. So there it says zombie. Oh right, oh I think I know that. Yeah, that guy. I think I've seen him on the internet before. So there's that information if you liked Zombie Gaga's facial tattoos. So. Alright, now they released information on this doll. Pre-ordering was available I think back in October on Amazon, Target, and Walmart. And I just received her, I think last week, so that was really cool. So in the bottom compartment is her spare outfit and doll stand. So there's that. So let's get this open. I usually just cut everything that I can. Oh, she even has her own fishnets. I always thought doll stockings were funny, but these are actually legit doll stockings. Like, they're little fishnets. I don't know if you can see fishnets. But they're kind of stiff, so, oh, they have a stretchy waistband, though. So let's see how that works out. Oh, they stretch out pretty well. I always thought that was one of the hardest things to dress your doll with was, doll stockings. Even as a child, I'm like, what the fuck? What's wrong with this? So, oh yeah, by the way, I do swear a lot, and that's why I've turned on the mature filter on my channel. So I try not to, because my niece and nephew usually watch. Sorry, Dad. But yeah, I just can't help it. So this is Zombie Gaga's second outfit, which, like, I do love the fashion, but I wish they would have given her something a little more glamorous. It is cute, and it says born this way with some barbed wire or something like that. So that's a little shirt dress that she wears with her fishnet stockings. Not that I'm complaining, I just feel like they could have given like Zombie Gaga something more glamorous. So I'm drinking iced coffee, by the way. It's the the prepackaged Starbucks iced coffee, cheaper than buying it every day. I only really got into drinking coffee at my last job. I was a supervisor on board for Emirates. So I was a flight attendant. And I had to get up, like, I had to be at work like a half an hour earlier than I used to when I became a supervisor. So I found myself, like, and we had a coffee shop inside where we checked in for work. So I found myself there, like, every time I was there for work. And I developed this thing. And I also wore Invisalign braces, so I couldn't drink hot drinks. And I'm not really a fan of, like, coffees and stuff. Hot tea sometimes, like, I did get into hot tea, but, like, hot coffees I wasn't drinking so much of. Ooh, I've already ripped it. So I got more into iced coffee because I could drink iced coffee while my braces were in. So I'm kind of now addicted to iced coffee. So I might be investing in an iced coffee machine. We'll see. Well, I don't even think I need to open this part. It's just a compartment. Okay. Never mind. Oh, okay, so let's go to this part. This is a really complicated box. So she's got, or should I open it from the bottom? Okay, no, let's go from the sides. I think. I guess this is the joy of unboxing because we have no idea what's going on. Okay, let me try back down here. Okay. Oh, it even says, it even says here, adult collector, so I don't have to feel so bad. But, I mean, all those other dolls that I got are for kids, but hey, what can you do? Okay, so that's done, and then I can open this flap here. I don't know if it's really going to do much. We'll see. This is such a complicated box. Let me just move all this stuff. So I don't drop it. Okay, we're getting somewhere. It's just taking a long time. Okay, so I got the bottom open, but she doesn't even come out, so I have to open the whole thing. Okay, let's keep going. So, what? I'm assuming that all these other plastic tabs are probably like this. Oh, focus, focus. Are probably like these, where they've got the little flaps, and I had to fold them in order to open it. So this is going to be a challenge, and I don't want to really damage the box. Or I could go for this. Wow, this is really challenging. What an interesting, what a complicated box for me to do for my first unboxing video, right? Okay, so I probably will have to rip this open, and I didn't really want to, but I'm gonna have to. Because... oh, I really don't know. I'm really not sure how to open this. Okay, so I'm just gonna have to rip it. I didn't want to, but I guess I will. So here we go. I'm sorry, Zombie Gaga. Oh, and if you didn't know this, like this beautiful, her face in the back here too. Oh, that's so cute. It says Lady Gaga is Zombie Gaga. And she's got the big bubblegum thing and her little glasses. Yeah, that's cute. All right, so I'm gonna keep ripping very gently. Yeah, there was no other way to open this actually because these tabs are like stuck in. This is some serious stuff. All right, so you can see these tabs are actually like, they're actually like looped in. So, and glued in. So yeah, there was no way to open it without ripping it. There we go. Maybe I can at least just do one. Do it all. Okay, so moving on, ripping the other side. Oh gosh, I really didn't. I'm kind of bad at this. You know, all these toy collectors out there are probably like dying watching me right now. Oh shit. Yeah, we ain't saving this box. Okay, wow, they really stuck all that on. I guess if I wanted to be able to take these off without cutting, I would have had to take this back off anyway. But usually I just cut all those tabs It's not like you're going to keep them. You're not going to put them back in, are you? And there's loads of glue as well. This is serious. I mean, it makes sense if this is for the adult collector. Usually, you know, when you open children's boxes, they're a lot easier to open because children are opening them, typically. But this is, like, covered with glue. So, there we go. And one more that's covered with lots of glue again. Jesus! All right, there we go. So then I can just lift this top part off, it looks like. And we should be a go with Lady Gaga, with Zombie Gaga. So there it is. Oh, she's so cute. She's so cute. So there's Zombie Gaga. She's so cute. She's got this like pinkish grayish hair. Actually, that should be my next hair color, right? Maybe. My cat's meowing a lot. I think I locked her in the room. Unbox fail. Just a second. I'll be right back. Locked in my room. All right, because I just moved in, I actually moved in with my family, and I converted my single car garage, because I have a three car garage. I converted my three car garage into a bedroom, but the door is quite heavy because it's an outside door, so they don't know how to open it. So anyway, let's get it out. So I'm just gonna cut all these pieces. So I'm going to put it on display eventually, once I get everything settled up, because like I said, I just moved back into the country last month, so I don't really have like spaces yet. I will eventually, especially once I get a job, and then I will be set. So this piece, she's got these crazy high stilettos on, because you know like Lady Gaga wears crazy high stilettos, and this doll has them as well. Jeez, they didn't look that tall on her when she was wearing her pants. So I'll just get these cuts. And then we'll take a look at her closer. Cut the ones for her hair. So, oops, these scissors are not the best. Pretty much pinned in everywhere, so just gotta be careful not to cut anything off of her. And they usually do this thing called like box hair, greasy box hair, and I don't know why they do this. I mean, I guess they think it will make the hair look better in the box, but they give dolls this like grease while they're in the box, and yeah, it does look nice, but then it has a weird texture. And I always find it strange how they always have these ones that's like stick in her head to pin her in the back. So sorry, Zombie Gaga. There we go. And there is one holding her in her waist. Oh, there were three in her head. Jesus. Like one was not enough. And she's free. All right. So let's put this box aside because it's pretty cray cray. Bye bye box. So I knew you can even see in the background, like it's a better shot of the background. It's kind of like disco ball glitter. Yeah, all sorts of cool stuff. So here we are. We've got Zombie Gaga now in all of her glory. And she's so pretty. Her hair actually has a lot more, looks like a lavender, gray, pink tone to it. It's actually quite soft. It doesn't feel that greasy, so that's okay. And they've got it in a little cute little semi-side pony, and they've wrapped it here. So she's really adorable, actually. I don't like, though, that these little... I can't remember what they're called. I used to work in retail. These little things that stuck out, the sticker to the box is still there. But I'll probably get some better scissors later to cut those off. So, yep, this is Zomby Gaga. I really love her hair. I want this to be my next hair. I don't know if I could pull that off, though. I mean, I probably, you know, I guess you can do anything, really, but that'd be a lot of bleach. And I can't damage my hair that much anymore. So Zomby Gaga has this little bubblegum bubble in her mouth. So let's take that out. Come on, Zomby Gaga. She really held it in there. So it's cute, but it does leave that little permanent hole in her mouth. But I guess if you're putting it on display, you would probably just display it with the bubblegum in there all the time. She does have really cute pale pink lips and the little, like, skeleton marks. And you can't see it, but she's even got glitter all up in her eyes. Some really pale purple and pink glitter. And she's just really cute. She's got little hearts on her eyeballs. I don't know. Let's see. This camera might be better. Yeah. So that's really cute. She's really adorable. And she's wearing her little suit. And that's Kiwi going. Kiwi's going through all my dolls there. Kiwi! Hey! No. So let's see. Let's check out what Zomby Gaga's outfit more closely. So she's got a little tuxedo jacket here. Close together. Oh, this is so cute. She's wearing suspenders and there's little hearts on the suspenders. So let's take this jacket off. Oh, I just broke her arm. Whoopsie. All right, I guess we better fix that. I just snapped her arm off. This arm doesn't want to move. Is that because I have the jacket on? Oh, this arm's still pinned to her side. So let's cut that off. All right, so I already broke Zomby Gaga's arm. So let's fix that. Oh, that's why. Because this one's also pinned to something. Alright. So I'm just gonna cut that bit off. I don't even know how or why, really. Like, they think she was gonna jostle around a lot. This isn't easy. Or maybe... I don't know. That's really strange. So, scissors I chose are not very good. So let's put Zomby Gaga's arm back in. But just to highlight the detail on her hands. So, there. Focus. How do I focus it? There you go. It actually has a little... skeleton and spider web, and then this one says lady and the little fingernails, and then as you can guess her other hand says Gaga. So Gaga, and it's turned a bit funny, so let's just shove this one back in. Ta-da! I'm just putting it back in. Oh, that was easy. And back to what? Or wait, what? Huh? So, strangely enough, this arm doesn't seem to move like this one does. Is that a malfunction? Oh wait, no, there it goes. So, it's just really hard to move. So... but it does come out pretty easily, so that's... that's a bit disappointing. Anyway, what I wanted to highlight on Zomby Gaga was that she had these really cute suspenders on. So she has these really, really cute suspenders on, and there's little heart details in the front and also on the back. So that's really cute. So there you can see her heart details on her suspenders. Yeah. I'm trying here. And on the back. And inside her jacket is a message, just in case you forgot and you need some empowering. It says, "Born this way." Born this way. So, really cute. Leave it up to Lady Gaga to add in all these details. It's actually a really nice fitted jacket, too. Like, I can see, like, all the darts and the pin tucks and everything. Okay, no pin tucks, but, you know, I just wanted to throw that word in there. But it's very streamlined. So, I wanted to mention again, as well as her shoes, she's got some crazy platforms. So, Lady Gaga's no stranger to crazy shoes. So these are Zomby Gaga's platforms. And I'm surprised that there's nothing this high in the current Monster High collection. But yeah, these are some crazy shoes. Oh, I forgot to cut that bit off. Let's cut that off. So yeah, these are Zomby Gaga's shoes. They're insane. Ta-da! If we take them off, they should be pretty easy to take off as well. Yes, I am going to undress Zomby Gaga on this stream because I want to put her in the other outfit and see what that looks like. You'd be afraid these would break, but they're actually pretty flexible. So, these stilettos, which is good, because if they broke, that would suck. As far as taking these shoes off, they're not easy. They have this gap in the back, which makes it, which they do with a lot of the Monster High shoes because they have a lot of crazy shoes. But I don't, like I said, I don't really take out my dolls often. I don't unbox them. Oh, I just pull it off. So I'm not really familiar with these. I guess you just pull them straight off. And she's got standard monster feet, which I kind of twisted. So, and then makes these trousers like extra, extra long. So, if we move on, we'll see her arms coming back out again. That's a little bit sad. If we move on, we're gonna remove her suspenders and her trousers. And I got a hint of a little skeleton underneath, so I think that she's gonna have some cute little body design. And I always find it funny because the Monster High dolls are so freaking skinny, which I know people are always like, oh, Barbie gives young girls confidence issues and blah 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 blah. Like, did it give me any kind of like self-esteem and confidence issues? No. That being said, being a little brown girl with, you know, brown-eyed girl, brown skin, and black hair, growing up in, like, West Phoenix, society and television and my friends, like, unknowingly did that enough. So I had enough self-esteem issues that a doll didn't have to do that for me. So, no, I don't believe that dolls give girls self-esteem issues. I think it's really, I think there's a lot more at work to that. But I got through all that stuff, you know. It didn't last very long. I had a very strong mother, a very, very powerful female figure in my life, so I was able to combat that. And I gained a lot of confidence in myself. So, oh, that's a bit disappointing. So she actually doesn't have the skeletal body that I thought she would, but she has a little bit of, like, neck design there, which is why I thought she would have, like, a little skeleton body, but I guess not. That's a little disappointing, Zomby Gaga. Oh well, she was born this way. Ah. So, still cute. So I'm gonna put this other outfit on her, so we're gonna put all this aside. All right, we'll keep the shoes because we gotta put shoes back on her, scissors aside. I haven't removed her sunglasses yet because that can get lost and I don't really have a place for her yet, so I'm gonna leave the sunglasses attached to her head. So back to these fishnets. these crazy, crazy fishnets. Oh, and they have that that seam down the back. So I'm assuming this goes in the back. So, and there's my cat again bothering me. So this, oh, they go on pretty easily. Oops, her toe got stuck in the fishnet. So yeah. Kiwi. Kiwi's bothering me. Oh, those fit really well. The seams kind of big because obviously it's doll clothes, but they don't quite give that same effect that they would, you know, in like pinup clothing and stuff. But there's the seam in the back. Kind of not amazing. So, and let's put this dress on her. Like I said, it's not so glamorous, but it's still cute. I just know that, like, you know, Lady Gaga's had tons of amazing outfits, like ridiculous. Okay, maybe not the meat dress, but I would have loved to have seen something a little more glamorous for her second outfit. I mean, the tuxedo is really cute and great, and it is very iconic of Lady Gaga, but there's so many more outfits. And I imagine with this coming out now, I do follow quite a few of doll customizers, because obviously that's what I want to get into, so I've been following some of them. And I know that once they get their hands on this doll, and her arm keeps coming loose, oh, disappointing. Once they get their hands on this doll, I'm sure they're going to make some custom outfits. Maybe I might eventually, if I have some time, if I can get into it. I really admire people that make doll clothes, because I tried when I was really, really young, because my mom was the one that taught me how to sew. So when I used to play with my Barbies, I did try to make doll clothes. It's really hard because obviously you have these tiny seams. Like, geez, I'm looking at this collar. Like, how do you make that collar? How you make it so tiny? So it's quite amazing what people can do these days. So yeah, so this dress went on really easily, as you can see. It's just got a little bit of Velcro on the back. Ta-da! And there she is. So cute. Actually, this reminds me of a dress that my friend Holly from the UK wore when we were in Vegas once, and she wore this really cute flannel dress, and kind of reminds me of her. Yeah. Put the shoes back on. These hopefully should go on easily, but now there's a lot of stuff in the way with the stockings. So, it's kind of there. I don't know if I'm going to get it on. I've seen pictures with her in this outfit and these shoes, so it's possible. It's just whether or not I can do it, I don't know. Okay. I don't want to rip a hole in these stockings. I'm gonna try. Okay. I don't think it's gonna happen. At least not from me, so I probably won't get it done. So, as Zomby Gaga, you're gonna have to go without shoes. That's okay. We'll deal with it later. And we'll go ahead and put her bubblegum bubble back, because I don't want to get it lost. So, there we go, and I'll go ahead and put it on the stand to finish this off. So these Monster High stands, actually, this one says Monster High on it, so you can see that, it says Monster High, I don't know if that's clear. There. And these are a bit different from the stands that I remember from Barbie dolls, which the Barbie doll ones like would stick right up their crotch, and this one goes around their tiny, tiny, tiny little waist. I can probably, oh no, can I put this under her dress? Whoop, and her arm's falling off again. That's okay, we'll put it around her waist here. So I just have to adjust it to match her waist. Oops. Yeah, this would have been a lot higher with her shoes, so without her shoes. She's just a cute barefoot Gaga. Shove her arm back in. Ta-da! And there she is. There is Zombie Gaga in her second outfit. It's pretty cute, right? Whoopsie! So, Zombie Gaga. I'm just gonna do a few tweets while you guys just wait 1 second. Okay, so that was Zombie Gaga. Zombie Gaga unboxing. Congratulations, you survived. So she'll probably have to go back in a box for now until I have a spot for her. Excuse me, my coffee. So hopefully that I'll find a spot for her soon because I really, really love her. And I love this hair, it's so cute. That's what I love about wigs is because you can wear wigs and you can get any color you want. My hair, actually, I got this done at the end of November. And it's not nearly as, well, it's not as vibrant as it was when I first did it. But yeah, when I left my job, because it was really, really strict on like our image and stuff, I was dying to, I was like, I have to get some colored hair. I was just dying for it. I was going for something a lot lighter than this, more of like a purple, kind of like a purple, like in Gaga's hair. And then this bottom part was supposed to be more blue, as you can see it's a little more teal, like here. It came out like this kind of magenta and bluish green the first time, which is fine. I understand, like, when you're coloring, like, in real life, hair doesn't always do what you want it to do. And I know everything you see on Instagram is usually, like, photoshopped and stuff. So I was still happy with it. And then I came to realize one of my friend Amy, who does hair here in Phoenix, is like, oh, that's actually called succulent hair, and it's a new thing. So, hey, I didn't know. I got into a very new trend. So I hope I can keep this hair in my new job. I'm no stranger to wigs, obviously, because I do cosplay. So we'll see. I might get it touched up, might try a different color. But yeah, this color is still from the end of November, and my roots have not grown too much. Anyway, she kept my roots natural so that when it does grow out, it doesn't show too much, so you can see. So it's really fun having colored hair. I forget a lot so that I have it. Okay, so end of that session is Zombie Gaga. Here's Zombie Gaga in her tux. And then this is, oops, let me move the, Zombie Gaga in her tux, and then Zombie Gaga in her second outfit. Super, super cute. So this one is gonna stay in the box forever. And this one will stay on a shelf and it will never be touched by anyone other than me, not even my child, one day. So. Ta-da. All right. So where can I put Zombie Gaga for now? Put her there. All right. So the next thing that I have are these Fright-Mares. So I have these Fright-Mares. I have a couple. Like I said, if you were just joining me, I moved from Dubai back to my hometown of Phoenix, Arizona, and I was living in Dubai for 6 years. So that was a huge change for me. I lived in Phoenix all my life, basically. And I was born in the Philippines. I moved over to Phoenix when I was just a baby. And Phoenix is pretty much what I call home. 6 years ago, I took a job as a flight attendant for Emirates Airline, and I moved to Dubai. And so I just came back. I resigned from my job. Came back to Phoenix last month, so I'm settling in. So I do have a lot of dolls. I have like 65 dolls, and those are like 65 boxes, not like counting each individual doll, because I have a few like box sets and stuff like that. So I do have a lot of dolls. When these Fright-Mares first came out, this is the first one. This one and the other one are the first two that I ever got. So these typically retail at $10 each. I did get a few cheaper, you know, I try and look for sales and stuff like that. So these two were the first two that I got, and this is airy ebb and fall, and they're kind of like, they're primarily centaurs with like different mixes. So you can see she's got like little skeleton wings. For those of you not familiar, they live in the catacombs underneath Monster High. So they're just really cute centaur type monsters. And this one is Bay Tide Chaser. So she has some sort of like sea monster type. It doesn't actually say. Oh, they actually have stories. I unlive for the ocean wind in my mane and the waves on my hooves. I mean, is there anything better than a gallop on the beach at dawn? I don't think so. And then Airy says, the darkest nights bring out the brightest stars, and there's nothing better than to watch the twinkling herd galloping across the midnight sky. Such deep words for like a children's toy. And that's kind of like why I like Monster High, is because it's like so like underneath, it's like so deep. And you know, I mean, the kids just love it because they're not these typical, you know, Barbie type blonde hair, blue eyed dolls, and they're all different. And that's kind of why I like it too, because I've never really fit into any kind of mold. And I always found myself kind of like different than everyone else. So to recap, I already have Fautine Fallowheart unboxed. I bought her actually, I found her in the UK recently. I actually had to unbox her because I didn't have space in my luggage. So I went to the UK last month just before I came to Phoenix. So I found her and grabbed her, and she was pretty cheap. She was like $5 or like £5, so it's like $7. So that's that. So I'm gonna go ahead and unbox one of these girls. Let's start with Bay Tide Chaser. So we're gonna start with Bay Tide Chaser, and there's Zomby Gaga there looking over everything. So these actually, it's already kind of like partly open. So these have actually been in storage for a couple of years. I kept them in storage while I was in Dubai. Yes, I did have this habit of buying dolls to this house and then having my sister put them aside. Yeah, I am guilty of that. Oh. So it would be nice to actually get these open. So these are typically pretty easy to open. And once again, like, my reasoning for opening certain dolls is, you know, the rarity of the doll, the cost of the doll, obviously. Like, Zomby Gaga actually was quite affordable now. She retailed for $30, and then Amazon actually had her on sale at some point, so I only paid $24 for each doll. But because she's a collector's edition, you know, I'm going to keep one in the box. A lot of my other dolls I keep in boxes. Pretty much all of my dolls I keep in boxes because that's just what I do. I just collect them. As far as these Fright-Mares, they are more on the cheaper side. And I started to keep them in, I was going to keep them in boxes, and I kept thinking to myself, I'm like, geez, you know, like, I have so many dolls in boxes, and these ones were only $10, so why am I so into keeping them in boxes when they were not as much as some of the other dolls that I have? So that kind of motivated me to start just opening them up and putting them on display. Also because I probably wouldn't have room for everything. So that's kind of the main reason why I decided to start opening my Fright-Mares. This is serious business, these boxes. So I'm not going to keep this box. I'm not too fussed about the condition that it's going to be in. So I'll do a little bit of ripping. Oh, that's always fun. So here's Bay Tide Chaser, and she's got that box grease hair as well. So we're gonna cut a little bit. I'm just gonna cut it, make it easier and faster. So she's really cute. She's green and pink colored. Reminds me a lot of Sailor Jupiter. Sailor Jupiter's my favorite Sailor Scout. I kind of have this like satisfaction feeling every time you like cut one of these things and they make like a pop sound. Now, as an adult toy collector, I'm totally not ashamed at all. I really don't care who knows that I collect toys. I always wanted to collect this kind of stuff. Obviously, like, you know, when you're younger, even in your 20s, you know, and you're struggling for money, there's so many things that you want to have and you can't, you know. I used to work paycheck to paycheck before I became a flight attendant. So it was hard because, you know, I mean, as a geek, there's so many cool things out there that you know, you want to collect. And when I finally was able to, like, you know, afford it on my own, and I could do that, it was exciting. What's up? Oh, my family just came home. I should probably schedule these around so I don't have so many interruptions. Anyway. So this one is, she's got those things on her head too. See? It's really weird because then you think, oh, these just stay in their head forever. Isn't that strange? It's really strange. Uh-huh. So, let's see. If I can get this one. There you go. And this one. What's up? What are you doing with my cat?
She made a beeline to this door.
Oh. Great. So, this is Bay Tie Chaser. Ta-da! See? And she's really cute. So, and this camera is better actually. There you go. And all of her accessories are still attached with clear rubber bands. So I usually just leave those on. Cause it's not like you have many accessories and stuff to interchange them with. So yeah. Ta-da! Okay. So Bay Tie Chaser has some sea accessories. She's got a little serpent tail, a little serpent mane or fin, and some wings. I'm not sure. And she's got a seahorse on her shirt. Seahorse on her shirt. Ta-da! So that's really cute. So these I like to keep on display, just as is. Whoops. She doesn't stand up. Focus. Ta-da! Okay. So that is Bay Tie Chaser. She's so cute. Alright, the second one I'm going to do is Airy Evanfall. Alright. Airy Evanfall. Just one second. So, this one's Airy Evanfall. Looks like she's a mix of a skeleton and she has horns and not sure. Airy Evanfall. So let's get this one open. This, like I said, this is one of the first two that I had bought when these first came out. I think they came out like 3 years ago. She looks a lot better on the picture on the back. I think she's a lot cuter in her cartoon form than she is in her doll form. But we'll see. We'll see how it goes. So there's Airy. Aha. So she's got some constellation theme on her leg. So let's get this one open. Trickier to cut these Fright-Mares out because they're such a weird shape. And these scissors are not the best, so. Maybe I can get it under her arm here. And then, of course, this one in the back. Just to make it really complicated. I mean, I know it's for display, but it's really, really complicated. And then she's got the two tags in her back of her head. That's a lot of fun. I can't even cut it. Like, I don't even know. I've almost got this one. This is like the last bit to unbox. And my scissors just, oh, there it went. Ta-da! So Aerie has two, oh, there's my other cat. Come here. Oh, this is my other cat. She rarely makes appearances because she's shy, but this is Lynx. So usually they, oops. Usually they come and interrupt everything I do when I'm on the computer. Oops. There's Zomby Gaga. There's Lynx. There's Lynx there. So if we look at Aerie Avonfall, she's got two different colors of hair. And the purple side is a lot softer than the black side. It's strange. Although I think because they didn't grease this bit. And she's got really cute bone wings. I have this thing for skeletons and stuff. I don't know why. I have a skeleton tattoo, or like a skull tattoo. And I just have this weird addiction to skulls. And one of my other favorite dolls, other than Ghoulia, is Skeleta, and she's the sugar skull monster, or Day of the Dead monster. Oh, why did you turn off? Oh. No. Sorry about that. I think my cat stepped on the power button. I'm not sure. Am I still here? Sorry, having technical difficulties. Okay, so I think I'm still here. Okay. So, going back to talking about Aerie. She's got these little horns, so I'm not sure exactly what kind of monster she's supposed to be. She does have just a traditional kind of like horse type tail, and she has the same kind of leg bracers, which these ones have little plastic lace ups on them. This is really cute. And her belt is made of bones, I guess. So there's that one. She's really cute. Yeah. She's really cute. So there's that. So I've got these that I've unboxed. These two with Zomby Gaga. And now I'm gonna move on to some Funko Pops. Now, the thing about Funko Pops is, I know everyone's crazy, crazy, crazy about Funko Pops, and I'm not really crazy about Funko Pops. I'm more crazy about collecting characters that I like that are Funko Pops, or in whatever form. Because if you collected all the Funko Pops, I mean, God, like, what, there's like over 400 now? I don't even know how many kind of Funko Pops there are. You would be collecting like a billion of them. So I typically just collect Funko Pops of characters that I like. And I was pretty stoked when I saw them come out with the Monster High ones, which I think are mostly Hot Topic exclusives. No, they are not. So I actually picked up, oh no. Sorry, my computer had to restart quickly and it closed down the chat, so I did not see the question. So sorry if I missed the question because my chat's clear. So go ahead and ask it again. If it comes up, I'll definitely answer it. Oh, okay. Alfarious Gaming, sorry I missed your question. My cat jumped on the power button and interrupted. What material is the black hair made of? It's definitely a synthetic. I think they're both the same. I think it's just because that box grease is mostly on the black part because that's what was flayed out in the display box. Because some of the purple part has the same texture. So I think it's the same actually. So. Yeah, I think because this bit was brushed underneath and it was flayed out like this in the box. I think this is why it just has more of that grease texture. Yeah. So, I collected a few of these Funko Pops. They actually had, this is one's, so this is Cleo and Claudine, and they actually have six of them in this collection. Now, why they have Skeleta, let's see this one. I'm not sure, because, I mean, that's one of my favorites, although she's not part of this original group, because this is mostly original group, minus Ghoulia, which I think they're taking Ghoulia out, because here she is on my shirt, and I haven't seen her in a lot of new products yet, lately, in the reboot especially. So, these ones I got some of them at Hot Topic, and some I got at the comic convention, which convention was it? Taiyocon in Mesa, which was just last weekend. So, I do have, who am I missing? One, two. Oh, I don't have Laguna here. I have Laguna, I just don't have her here. Not sure where she is. Anyway, so I do have five of them, except Skeleta. I wasn't able to find Skeleta, and I kind of have a feeling she might be a rare one. I'm not sure why, but I do have these four. So we're going to unbox these now. And like I said about Funko Pops, I'm not crazy about Funko Pops themselves. I just more or less like my favorite characters. So I know some people are like crazy about their Funko Pops, like they keep the boxes and they put them in display boxes, and strangely enough, I'm not that fussed about like preserving them, which I know I should be, but I'm not. So I'm just going to unbox them and I'll probably just throw the box away. So here is Claudine. Claudine, oh, sorry about the glare. There's Claudine, Claudine Wolf. And for those of you that don't know much about Monster High, I'll repeat it again. It's made by Mattel, and they're basically these monsters, children of these famous monsters, that all go to the same school, Monster High. And Claudine is the daughter of the werewolf, and she actually has a younger sister, an older brother, and an older sister. And her younger sister's name is Howlene, and her older brother is Claude, who is dating Draculaura, and her older sister is Claudia, who works in Huntleywood as a director or writer or something like this. So this is Claudine, and I used to not really like Funko Pops because I thought their heads were so big and their faces were so unrecognizable, but I am quite impressed on how much detail they can get in this tiny little thing. So there's Claudine. It's quite easy to unbox these. So there's Claudine. And you can see all the details there on her dress, her outfit, her shoes. Focus that. And I never realized this, but there's a stand in here. And I've unboxed a few other Funko Pops before, and I don't ever recall seeing a stand. Is that bad? I might have accidentally thrown the stand away. Is that standard with Funko Pops? Whoopsie. Although it doesn't seem to fit her feet. She's got these little holes. So there's one bigger hole and one smaller hole, which I can see. Maybe I just need to move her leg over a little bit. So I'm a bit sad if I did accidentally throw away all those other stands, because that's pretty cute, a little stand. That's Claudine, Claudine Wolf. So she's got little pierced wolf ears. She's pretty sassy. She's a sassy character. So there's that one. So, and she stands really well on that stand. There she is. And let's take Draculaura. Now, Draculaura is the daughter of Dracula. So she's a vampire. She's a vegan vampire. So no, she does not drink blood. What she does or eat or drink, I actually can't remember. So she's actually 1600 years old. There was a series called Sweet 1600 for Draculaura, and I'm pretty sure there was a movie. I can't remember. These are all on Netflix if you guys are ever interested, if you're ever bored. I have seen them, almost all of them. And she's also, by size, she's the smallest one. So even in the dolls, what I like about Monster High is that they make different sized dolls as well. So there's like four or five different molds, I think, for doll sizes. And Draculaura has the smallest one. So she does have a coffin that she does sleep upside down in. And she has kind of a little, like, Transylvanian accent. But she's really, really cute. Although her skin should be tinted pink, which this Funko Pop is not tinted pink. So there's little Draculaura. the details again on her dress. It's quite good. Now, when I did a cosplay group with the girls in Dubai, one of the girls there was Draculaura. She was really cute. So Draculaura always has this little heart on her cheek. So yeah, it's a quite nice Funko Pop. Even her little nails are painted red. So, and then again, this one has a stand, which I'm kind of bummed if that, if those other ones that I had stands and I just threw them out. Oops. I'm kind of a terrible collector. Like, I'm not like hardcore or anything. I just collect what I like. So that one we put in. Oh, this is a lot easier to put in. Ta-da! So there's Draculaura. All right, let's move on to Cleo. Cleo is the daughter of the mummy, which is pretty vague because there's like not just one mummy, unless we're like going off of like The Mummy, the movie with Brendan Fraser. But whatever, I guess that's thinking too deep into it. So yeah, Cleo is, she has an older sister named Nefara. Who's pretty evil. Now, Cleo has this kind of mean girl vibe, but she actually has a good heart. She just has a lot of pressure from her father, the pharaoh, or the ex-pharaoh, or whoever it's supposed to be. So Cleo is probably the only doll that doesn't have colored skin, I think. She's supposed to have that kind of, like, olive texture. So assuming that if we're going to talk, like, where she's originally from, it would be Egypt. So she kind of has that kind of Egyptian olive-colored skin. So, and she tends to wear some like heavy kohl eyeliner, and I don't remember her having this little jewel on her eye, underneath her eye, but there she has it. Giant earrings, and then her clothes are kind of like a wrap, and she's got her little like Egyptian pose, Egyptian mummy pose going on. So there's Cleo. Super cute. And of course her stand as well. Now Cleo and Gulia is actually like Cleo's best friend. So, whoops, Zombie Gaga. So that's why I'm a bit sad that I haven't seen Gulia in the reboot. The reboot's kind of disappointing. Like, they completely rewrote the whole series of Monster High, I guess to make it more child-friendly, or I'm not sure, really. But it's kind of good that I'm not interested in the reboot, because then I won't be buying so many of the new dolls. I mean, there are a few that I like. I did buy the Welcome to Monster High with Moanica and Draculaura, because Moanica is the new zombie character they brought in, which I think is there to replace Gulia, which is sad, because I still like Gulia. So there's Cleo, ta-da! And the last one that I have, I really don't know where Laguna is. This is Frankie. She's kind of seen as, like, the main character of Monster High, and like I said, when they debuted Monster High at San Diego Comic-Con in 2010, I really want to say it was, she was their Comic-Con exclusive. They had her in the original box, like the first wave that they call it, but it was all black and white, and it came with an outer box protection, and it was really affordable. It was like $30, because like now they're like $80 or $90 for the San Diego Comic-Con exclusives. So Frankie is by default one of my favorites. I did cosplay Frankie last year. And that was my first kind of venture into body paint, which I've been wanting to get into body paint long before that, but it just seems so intimidating. But I'll show you a picture of my Frankie cosplay, and it was a lot of fun. I had one of the girls, like I said, I joined a group, a cosplay group of sisters in Dubai for the Middle East Film and Comic-Con last year, and one of the sisters is a makeup artist, so she actually applied my face paint, my body paint, actually. I did use Ben Nye for that, and that was a very amateur mistake. I have done more research into better body paints, so I did buy an airbrush, and I'm kind of getting into that as well, so that's another project that I want to improve upon. So that was when I was Frankie at Middle East Film and Comic-Con in Dubai last year. So my earrings are made by Steam Wolf Symphony. It's my friend Candace, who does a lot of really cool like headpieces and jewelry and stuff. So, and then my lipstick, I actually wear Lip Sense. It's like a kind of like a permanent lipstick. I use it for work a lot, so it's really good for cosplay as well, because you don't need to reapply it all the time. For people that don't think that makeup is important when you cosplay, it's so important, because when you see your photos later, you're just like, oh, why do I look like that? So it's just really good to, like, you know, help with a flash or redness or anything like that. It doesn't have to be a full face of makeup. And the costume, actually, I try to make everything from scratch. It's just hard in Dubai because I didn't have all the resources that I could have had. So I actually bought a child's costume in a, like, a large or an extra large, and then I, because I wanted to have that exact same plaid, and it's impossible. So I bought a child's costume, and I took everything apart except for the plaid. So I kept the plaid. I think I shortened the skirt, and I added everything else. So I redid the white collar part. I redid the tie. I made a real belt for it instead of the foam belt. I added tulle and more tulle underneath the skirt. So I redid the costume pretty much all of it. So those are the other girls that I was with. There were three sisters. It was Rafael, Salem, and Lara, and they were so cute. We did a dance on stage too, so that was a lot of fun. So I had a blast doing Frankie, and then I came to Phoenix Comic Con last year. Oh, when did I do that? Middle East Comic Con, that's April. And then I came to Phoenix Comic Con last year, and I cosplayed as Frankie, and then my niece dragged me around by the hand, calling me Frankie all day, so that was really cute. So that was at Phoenix Comic Con with my little niece. Oh, it was so much fun. And she was like, Frankie, come on, let's go. And then there's another picture of me and the other girls at Middle East Film and Comic Con. There's Cleo, Draculaura, and Claudine. So that was a lot of fun. So I did do that costume. So Frankie's always going to be up there as one of my favorites because she's an original. So here's the Frankie Funko Pop. She looks really, really sassy. And there's a little mark on her hair. I don't even know where that came from. But yeah, the details on here, not as good as the other ones. And it's funny because her neck bolts are actually underneath her head. They should be on her neck, but they're underneath her head, so that's strange. But I guess the way these are made, you can't really fit that in. But yeah, she's really cute. She's got all her little stitches. Yeah. I'll put her on her stand as well. And then these I will definitely be putting on display all together at some point when I get the shelves for it. That's always how it is with collectors, isn't it? Like, when I get the shelves, when I do this, when I do that. And everything kind of stays in boxes. Only collectors can understand that. Is this working? I'm having problems. Oh, here we go. Oh, finally. So there we go. There is Frankie Funko Pop. And there are all the girls. These are all the people we unboxed today. Zomby Gaga. Ta-da! Oops. Sorry, Frankie. And also the Fright-Mares. There's Airy Avonfall. I'll just hold them. So these were all our unboxing today. That was fun, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. I probably will do another unboxing video shortly. I'll write it on my schedule. I'm going to try and get back into gaming for tomorrow. Tomorrow I'm going to do Overwatch for the first time with my family, so that'll be a lot of fun. So if you want to watch a noob fail on PC gaming on Overwatch, please tune in tomorrow. The time is... what is the time? I think we're going to be doing it around... well, time is to be announced, so I'll announce it tomorrow. So that's it, guys. Thank you so much for joining in. I'll see you later.